In this video, we will learn about the bag of words-based document term matrix and attempt to implement it through coding. Before watching this video, it may be helpful to watch the bag of words video for better understanding. In the previous video of bag of words, we explained that the bag of words method is a text encoding technique that represents text in numerical form. The vectors generated using this bag of words method are then arranged into a matrix, known as a document term matrix. Each row represents a document, and each column represents all the words in the corpus. If a particular word appears twice in a document, it is represented as 2, and if it doesn't appear, it's represented as 0. This way we can represent the frequency of each word in each document. Here, let's consider three sentences. Lee likes apples, Lee likes bananas, and Lee likes bananas, and Lee likes bananas. First, we'll tokenize the sentences into words and build a vocabulary list by removing duplicates. So, for the three sentences, we have a vocabulary list consisting of the words and, apples, bananas, Lee, and likes. We assign an index or order to each word in this order, starting from 0 and going to 4. When we represent the frequency of vocabulary appearance for each sentence in vector form, it looks like this. For the first sentence, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. For the second sentence, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. For the third sentence, 1, 0, 2, 2, 2. In this way, using the bag of words method, we express each document in terms of word frequencies, and then represent it as a matrix, which is precisely what we call the document term matrix. The document term matrix treats all words equally, regardless of their relevance or informativeness or association within the document. Additionally, it's sensitive to sentence length, meaning that as a sentence gets longer, the word frequencies increase, potentially causing bias in the analysis. Furthermore, stop words like and, the, is, etc. typically don't carry much information but tend to appear frequently. Treating these words equally with other words in the document term matrix can dominate the representation due to their high frequency. Now, let's try implementing the document term matrix in code. You can find this Jupyter notebook file on GitHub, so feel free to download it and run it directly. First, we'll import the pandas and numpy libraries. Additionally, we'll import the count vectorizer library to numerically represent the text data based on word frequency. We'll store the three sentences Lee likes apples, Lee likes bananas, and Lee likes bananas and Lee likes bananas in the documents variable. After tokenizing the sentences into words and building the vocabulary list by removing duplicates, we'll have a vocabulary list of 5 words: and, apples, bananas, Lee, and likes. Representing the frequency of each word, the vectors would be, for the first sentence, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. For the second sentence, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. For the third sentence, 10222. These vectors enable the computer to understand the text.